rock appreciation and theory.
46.
Ugh.
I just uploaded 44 and sent it to Jordan, and he was like, episode goat. I was like, what does that mean? Well, 44 is the number of Lewis Hamilton.
Oh, yeah.
Like, fuck's sake. How did I not think about that?
Should have deleted that one. Just skip to 45.
44.1.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it. That's a good name for him.
44.1 is the...
KPBS?
No, yeah, the industry standard kilobytes sample rate.
Sample rate, yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's on CDs, isn't it? Mostly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can I start? With my only one?
No. Yeah, go on.
Muse's new album came out.
Oh, yeah, is it fully out?
Fully out.
Fully out. Fully emerged.
There is one, like the main one I was going to play, but then I found another one that I think you'd like more.
Okay, okay.
And I know for a fact it's going to get copyrighted, so here we go. I just think you'll enjoy the sounds in it. But who knows?
I most likely will. Did they play at Leeds, Muse? Just gone?
I don't think they did, no. They usually do, but yeah. I think it was Arctic Monkeys that played there. Yeah, exactly.
It sounds like Muse.
Yeah. I love watching him drum, man. So good. It's a good blend of synth and also rock in it.
Yeah.
I'd love to listen to just the bass as well. I bet that's so naughty.
It's just so simple.
Yeah.
Like, the elements themselves.
Yeah.
They just pop.
Yeah. A good one to get us going.
Can you hear Knights of Cydonia in that? It's like almost the exact same line.
Yeah, I get what you're saying, yeah. That's probably why I like it. It's like vintage Muse.
Guitar's mint in that.
Mint, mate.
Mint, mate. I don't need to go with that now, because my songs that I've chosen are nothing like that. But
it's fine. I don't think I'll pick anything like that again for this episode.
There is similar that I could pick.
Anyways, I knew we had to show you one from that album. That was, I've not listened to it enough yet to know them all individually.
Yeah,
I'm still at that stage, which is a fun stage to be in.
I think I'll get on a listen, I think, because
quite varied.
I like the one that you showed me a couple of episodes back, where it was the one they teased for it. They released the single, and then
I watched his full interview with do you know Zane Lowe, the DJ? He's with Apple Music now, and he just does like full hour interviews with certain artists.
Yeah,
and he did one with Matt Bellamy, and it was really cool.
Oh, that sounds nice.
But like, I'm a bit annoyed they've only announced like four UK dates next year.
Yeah, it's weird that they are British, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah, they're from like Devon area down south.
It makes no sense, but whatever.
I think they all live in LA though now.
Oh, right. They're just used to that life.
Don't use my phone.
No, it's alright. I just literally did it, and I just cleared my throat right.
I need like a plug-in just to get rid of
noise gate every time I speak. Who's it by? I need to see all songs. Why are you only showing me four? No. Okay. Bing bong. There it is. Just a nice, short, sweet song that I found from this band that I don't know if they play anymore, but I think I found them because through a new project they did.
Right.
Or like a side project. I found that, and then I was like, oh, okay, they're from this band. And then I think that's what it was anyway. But this is on like my... Jesus.
This mic doesn't help. Like, you can probably hear it. Like, oh,
you can hear every... Yeah, I just sound like ass. I can't remember what I was going to say. I'm just going to play it.
It's a good episode of this. I never know what you're going to play, and it's always a surprise. It's never like, I just play stuff that you already know. That song you showed me where like the album cover was like the tide on the beach, and it was just a really complex
that's it. This is those same people, I think.
Is it? Yeah, it's very similar. Well, it's not similar, but it's same style.
Yeah.
I love the separation on the guitars, like the panning is so cool.
I just love the syncopated kick drums of the chords. You can make drums sound like bullets, I mean.
I love syncopated but in sync chugging.
Yeah, that's what I mean, the digga 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 digga. That's it. It's just like a little.
I expected it just to come straight back.
Yeah,
in. I like that. It's just a quick little. gets you done.
Yeah, hit that stuff you need.
Yeah, I do think the word chug is horrible.
There's no other way to describe that though, is it? Chug.
Bit of chug on that, mate.
Chug. I'm not even gonna say it.
Yeah.
Chug on that biff, lad. I mean, yeah, my next two are going to be like completely different to that, so, you know, go wherever you want with it.
I'm going to.
Oh, God.
I think I might have to resort back to iTunes rather than Spotify. Even though I've got it on Spotify. It's on Spotify, of course it is. Everything's on there. This is a band I used to absolutely tan when we were at school, but I've not really listened to since.
Tan them.
I used to tan them, mate. Yeah.
Ooh.
I'm surprised I've not played them yet after 45 episodes. It ends so strongly as well, this song. This album came out in 2010, and it was like quality, like front to back, just so good. Top 10 satisfying solos as well, like,
oh,
yeah.
I don't listen to much, like, I don't actively listen to Bullet for my Valentine, but I feel like I have to now.
This album, start with this album and then.
Yeah.
I think after this, I just sort of forgot about them. I just remember listening to this, like, on East Pine Square airwalks. Like, I used to wear, like, wristbands as well.
Yeah, man. I'd have loved this if I'd heard it back then. Change of rhythm, Batman.
Like you feel throughout the song, he's just getting more and more pissed off. Like.
Yeah.
Very metallically inspired.
Yeah, octaves.
Guitar, yeah. But you know where it's going as well, and it's just.
Yeah, it's kind of just feel.
Like, energy.
That's the only point it's gone half time in the song. And then, oh yeah, brilliant.
You like it?
That was so good. Yeah, I'm gonna. I'd say send me that after this, and I'll listen to the album.
What are you feeling like? Give me.
I'd say go on the same wavelength because my last one's going to be like that. So it's.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. I I'm in this headspace now. This okay. Headspace. Oh, is this live?
Live.
Oh my god.
But it's in Ireland. And it's an Irish song. How's that volume?
Down a little bit more. Yeah, be right. That is a nice guitar.
Just makes you want to be in a band, doesn't it?
Yeah. What a fucking cool band.
Yeah. But I heard these perform this, well, I saw the music video for it before I knew the original, yeah. So I just prefer this, it's just yeah. So much better.
I'm the same.
Yeah.
It's the, just the melody on that guitar just sounds so good, like.
I bet it's quite a straightforward song to learn as a band as well.
Like, yeah.
But still fun to play.
Like, even if you just focus on the rhythm, it sounds so good, the chords. Like this. That climb down, so good.
Down the scale,
yeah, and, yeah. It goes, and yeah. That like little dun dun dun
to get
back
to the
back to the root,
yeah.
No, yeah.
Jaro.
Yeah. That castle just behind them, that's me.
It's a quite a popular venue. It's obviously in Ireland, but I think Red Hot Chili's played there in like 03 and it was like one of the best concerts ever. Like, that's not an active, is it? Is it?
Not an octave, no. I think there's like a fifth or a third up. I think it's probably the nature of the original, but like their version feels like a journey, like a story. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like after that big solo and it kind of drops down again.
That's the thing, I don't know anything memorable about the original. But yeah. This is like, I don't know, you've got to want to love a song a lot to cover it.
Yeah.
So this obviously means a lot to them and it comes out, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, he likes whiskey.
Whiskey!
That was mint. Actually, no, it was shit.
It's like trying to get him off stage. Whiskey!
Who the fuck? Yeah. Right, it's between... Alright, I'll do this one.
Acoustic version.
Just mint song, mate. I think this is my favourite of theirs.
It's like that Chug again.
Yeah.
It's just very noughties, isn't it?
Yeah.
Or like early 10s. Like, I really remember that era so well. Like,
yeah.
Early 10s.
It's just such a good sound to encapsulate. Yeah.
Being at school, being someone who listens to this sort of stuff and just sort of not knowing where you fit in. It's
yeah.
Like,
oh. I think my favourite thing about A Day to Remember is how the drums are prominent. Yeah. That's one of the things that always leads me back to them.
It has to be, though. For this genre of music, it has to be.
Because everything feels driving. Every time the drummer changes the rhythm or starts bringing in the ride, you feel yourself like... And obviously the lead singer, I love his voice.
Sometimes it's better when you got a simpler drum pattern, just just feeling it.
Yeah, it's only kick, kick, snare, kick, kick, snare, kick, kick, snare, and some fills. Love this bit now.
Let's swap the bass and the drums around, the snare and the patterns, and
just to bring you back into it.
I love songs that feel like they're a jam, like they've been made in like the same day. Like
yeah.
They've just gone for it, you know what I mean? Yes. I wanted one more.
I nice. I enjoyed that. That was didn't go the way I expected, but
yeah, that was actually quite good. It's like a Rocky episode. Yeah, full on. We never really stick to one genre, do we?
Yeah, no.
Probably I just derail it with like Brian video or something.
Like a 12-minute snarky puppy.
Yeah. Not got any of them this week, mate.
Oh man. Yeah, good stuff. Oh.